Hello everyone, today I will show you different methods to upgrade the firmware. I'm going to use the DrayTek Vigor2927 to do the demonstration. First, let's go to DrayTek.com.au and download the latest firmware. Go to Support, Downloads. To quickly find the model number, simply enter the model number on the search bar. There are two types of files with the same name in the firmware folder. Using the .al file will upgrade the firmware and retain all the existing settings. On the other hand, using the .rst file will upgrade the firmware and will reset the router to factory default settings. So be aware of that when you upgrade the firmware. We are going to use the .all file throughout the demonstration. The first method to upgrade is through the router web management page. Go to System Maintenance, Firmware Update menu, click on Choose File button and select the firmware file from your PC. Click on Upgrade button to start the firmware installation. Once the firmware file has been uploaded, click on Restart to apply the settings and reboot. The second method is using the firmware upgrade tool. This software can be downloaded from our download page under Utility. Start the upgrade utility and you will see this message. Click OK to disable the firewall to avoid corrupted firmware upgrade. Enter the router IP address. Select the firmware file. Enter the router admin password. Leave port and timeout at default setting. Open the command prompt and make sure the PC can ping to the router. Then click Send to start. A pop-up message will appear at the end, showing the router is now active. Now comes to the third method, upgrading the firmware using FTP client. We need to first set up the FTP server in the DrayTek router. Go to System Maintenance, Management menu, select Allow Management from the Internet and the FTP server, and check the FTP port. Note that this method will only work with older router, and this feature has been removed from the later model routers. In this video, we will demonstrate using the Vigor2820 router, which was discontinued some time ago. Now start the FTP client. In this example, here we are using FileZilla. Enter the router WAN IP address, username and password, and the FTP port 21. Click Quick Connect and OK to proceed. Now drag and drop the firmware file to the router. During the firmware upgrade, the webpage of the router shows upgrading the firmware. Once the firmware is transferred, terminate the FTP connection and close the FTP client. The router should perform a reboot and upgrade the firmware itself. If the router did not reboot, go to System Maintenance, Reboot System, and click Reboot Now. The fourth method is upgrading the router using forced TFTP mode. We also recommend client to reflush the firmware using this method when there is a corrupted firmware. To get into the forced TFTP mode, first turn off the router. then use the pin to press and hold the reset button on the front panel of the router. While you are holding the reset button, power on the router. Wait until the LED light starts flashing, then release the reset button. Note that the flashing pattern may vary on different models. Start the upgrade utility. Enter the router IP address. Select the firmware file. Enter the router admin password. Leave port and time at default settings. Open the command prompt and make sure the PC can ping to the router. Then click send to start. Once the upgrade is complete, go to dashboard page and verify. The fifth method is upgrading the firmware via ACS3. Before upgrading the firmware on the management devices, we need to first upload the firmware files to the ACS3 server. To do this, go to the file manager within the maintenance page. We will need to have the required user group selected. In our example here, we select the SD-WAN user group. Now click on upload. Select the firmware file from your PC. We have uploaded the Figure 2927 firmware here. Now go to the firmware upgrade menu. Check that the correct user group is selected. Then click on the add icon. Enter a name for the profile and select enable. You can run the upgrade immediately by selecting now or later by using the schedule. For the schedule setup, enter the start and end times as well as the date. Next, select the required firmware. Then select the device to upgrade, which is the Vigor 2927 router. Click Save to save the profile and initiate the task.